Say hey, Yellow Jacket football fans. Welcome to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. And Coach, Cartersville's got a pretty good ball team, and we've got a lot of things to work on, right?
Yes, we do. You know, you got to give credit to Cartersville. They've got a really, really good football team. They got skill all over the field. They got a tremendous quarterback, and they were a lot better up front than I gave them credit for on both sides of the ball. They're a really good football team, but, you know, we've got a long way to go. You know, we took a step backwards, but, you know, and it starts with me. I did a poor job of coaching this football team this week, and we're going to get better. It's just going to take us a little time to overcome this, and because we got beat in every phase of the game, and it was embarrassing is what it was. But, you know, I like the character of our kids. I think we're going to come back, and we're going to get better.
And we've got a bye week, so we've got 2 weeks of practice to get ready before we open up region play. Great atmosphere at the Reeve. I mean, it was deep around the fence. The stands were full. It was a playoff-type atmosphere. It was a beautiful night.
Yeah, I think it was a little overwhelming for some of our football players, you know, with the type of team that Cartersville is and with the crowd that we had. And it was an awesome atmosphere.
Yes,
and
was.
I just wish we could have played better. But, you know, again, you got to give credit to Cartersville. I think they're a very, very good football team. I think they'll go on and win the state championship in Quad A because they got all the tools.
Yes,
they're well coached. They got tremendous athletes. And, you know, they got the five-star quarterback. That's, you know, he's tremendous.
He's a really good throwing quarterback. We're going to take a timeout. We're going to come back and take a look at the first half highlights. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Welcome back, Yellow Jacket football fans. And as we said earlier, it was a beautiful night at the Reeve. A little bit of more breeze than I thought, you know, about a 7-8 mile per hour wind blowing from the north. Then halfway through the game, it shifts and blows from the south to the north. But it a lot of fans, just a great atmosphere.
Yeah, it was. You know, I really appreciate the support that we got tonight. And, you know, I think everybody in Northwest Georgia was at this game.
I think so.
But, you know, it was a great atmosphere, and it was, you know, we got beat by a very good football team.
Well, the guys did a lot of good things, and we're going to see that on tape. Captains for tonight's game
are? You got Beck Fletcher, Red Abernathy, Cade Walker, and William Long.
Big Cade Walker. We win the coin toss and take the ball.
Well, I probably messed up, and, you know, we didn't want to give them an extra possession,
right.
Number one, so... but the wind was blowing, and I really should have took the wind, to be honest with you.
And they have a very good kicker, too.
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, they've got it all now. They've got, you know, from the kicking game to offensive line to defensive line, they're very good. Very good football team.
We came out working the 25-second play clock, didn't we?
Yes, we did. We wanted to slow the game down, and we feel like we got a really, really good play here. And for some reason, we don't stay outside with it.
Yes.
I mean, that's on us. We've got to do a better job of seeing the holes and running where we're supposed to run.
Second down and long.
We got a good play here, and, you know, we're trying to throw a little pop pass here, reading the linebacker, and number four jumps up and knocks the ball down.
And he did that a couple times during the night. So, yeah, this is an aggressive front out of the 3-4 that they walk their outside linebackers up, makes it look like a five-man front. And give Cartersville credit. They get to the ball. They close to the ball quickly.
Yeah, they do. And they're slanting front, which, you know, it's pretty easy to block them if you know which way they're going. But it's very difficult to block a slanting front. And, you know, they're good at what they do. Really good.
Nice tackle by Owen Williams there. Spun the guy around, and obviously he's got good balance. He kept going, but that's a pretty dangerous kick returner also.
Yep, and then they, to start the game, you know, they start on the 39-yard line, which that's difficult for anybody.
Yeah. We back them up 5 yards with an illegal procedure penalty, and I thought they could have called the illegal procedure on about every play on their play.
Yeah, I did too. I told a guy almost every play.
Yeah. They got quick starts. Quarterback drops back, and this young man has a nice arm.
Yeah, he does. And, you know, we got it played there. We just, you know, I told Ryan, you know, it's just like playing center field. I mean, just the ball's in the air, go get it. You know, it's just, it's ours just like it is theirs. And he got turned around, and but we had it covered.
Second down from the 44-yard line. And this is their transfer in. And he plays an outside linebacker. He plays a tight end. And this is a pretty good athlete.
Yeah, he's supposedly committed to Wake Forest, and force all said and done, I think he'll go somewhere bigger than that because he is a really good football player. And again, you know, they've got about, I'd say, five or six transfers on this team that came in and really helped them.
It really filled out their depth.
Yep,
I mean, it really helped the starting lineup. Yeah,
he's a senior transfer, you know, and he's a good player. You got to give him credit.
Exactly, yeah. And, you know, the coaching staff will enjoy working with them. All right, we line up first and 10, and, Coach, this is going to be the story of the first half starting from our 20-yard line.
Yeah, you know, we just felt like we needed to get some first downs to, you know, change the field position. And, you know, we get 7 or 8 yards on first down there, and good run by Alico.
Yeah, we'll make it second and 2, and Robbie's Raiders doing a good job on that play. Go double tights, pistol formation. And like
and
we
they're
said,
they're just whipping us up front. They're right now they're better than us. You know, that's the bottom line. They're a better football team, and but I was disappointed in our fight. You know, we needed to play better than we did. You know, they are a better football team than us. They were going to beat us, but they're not 56 points better than we are.
I would agree with that assessment. Aaron Hayes on to do the punting.
And we got. I thought Aaron. You know, he's just a 10th grader. He's young, and he didn't do a bad job except for one time. I mean, you know,
exactly.
we can't afford shank punts in games like this, but we'll get better.
Exactly. Two receivers, left and right, drop back. And, Coach, I was kind of surprised. I know they've got this young gun at quarterback, illegal procedure again. I'm surprised they didn't run the ball more because Creamer's a really good running back, and they can do some things, but they really rely on this kid's arm.
Yeah,
which I mean,
they got the best of both worlds.
They
can throw it, they can run it, and you know, 12's about 6'4", 6'5". And the bad thing for us is a lot of these kids are coming back next year.
Yes.
I mean, they only have about 10 seniors on this team, but they have like 30-something juniors.
Yeah, and 4 of their 5 starting offensive linemen are juniors.
Yep.
So we were talking during the game, the only person happier than the coach is the quarterback.
Yeah.
So we've got another penalty on Cartersville here. So illegal procedure. These two guys at the bottom just get quick starts all the time. Little flare out into the left flat. Puts his shoulder down and runs hard, and that's Creamer, the running back.
Yeah, Creamer's got 4.4 speed. You know, he's got offers all over. You know, he's probably got 20 offers already. You know, he's a really good player. It's a good cut right there.
And that second cut was really good.
We just got out athleted there. Man, ain't a whole lot you can say about that.
I agree. Yeah, I like this kicker. He reminds me of Adam Griffith. He gets the ball high.
Yeah, he's a good kicker.
Yeah. So they're going to kick off to us again. As you can see, the score was 7-17 left in the first quarter.
So it's obviously not the start we wanted.
No.
You know, we wanted to sustain a drive and milk some clock, and we're struggling getting the first down.
Line up in double tights. Alico behind Balaam. We fake to Alico. Scramble. And nuts. Just got an ankle, number 15 did. And would have been nice to see what Balin could have done if he'd gotten to the edge.
Yeah, I think we had a big play there if we could have got rid of it.
Pressure. Balin did a good job of getting that. And
that's a good job by Balin getting rid of the ball. And, you know, we didn't block it up. You know, we had them all blocked up, supposedly, and we missed assignment here or there and put pressure on the quarterback. And we're a false start here.
Yeah, they get us for illegal procedure. They walk the outside linebacker up, and Balin rolls to the right, and he's looking for his brother downfield. Got a little bit of a late push there.
Yeah, we're trying to get him on a little out and up there, and they played it pretty good.
Yes, they did. So Aaron's going to punt again. Got good hang time on this. He called for a fair catch really late and stuck his arm up. We gave him a little bit of a hit, and the referees decided not to call any penalties, which wasn't any penalty on us. I didn't like the late fair catch.
I want to know why that wasn't a penalty, because you fair catch it, you're supposed to stop. And he said he blew it dead when he caught it. So,
little running play with Lawrence to the left, and he is fairly agile in the pocket also. Now, quick down and out to the right-hand side. They're down to our 30-yard line. Two receivers right, two up top on the left, and Balin playing outside linebacker or rover.
Yep, we finally got some pressure on him. We played better, in the second half defensively,
exactly.
In the third quarter especially. I thought we got a little fire in us the third quarter, but, we've got to get better, obviously, across the board.
They pushed the field goal to the right. It was a 42-yard attempt, and we're going to keep the score the same, and we're going to take over. Unfortunately, in high school, on a missed field goal, the ball spots at the 20 instead of from the line of scrimmage. So Aliko runs hard on behind the left side of that Robbie's Raiders line, gets good positive gain.
We got Gavin here at quarterback with a little package that we put in this week. And
I like this package.
I think if Balin stays outside a little bit there, we got more yards. But, we do get, it's third and five, third and four. And we throw a little hitch out here, and I think Malik's got to go up with two hands and catch that ball.
Yeah. So it's going to bring up fourth down, a punting situation. Yeah, I like that package with Gavin in there.
Yeah, we're going to have to be creative. It's a good thing that we've got a good job by Jacob Callahan.
Hey, Jacob snapped the ball with a good snap, and then he gets downfield and makes a one-on-one tackle. That was a nice play. Got him backed up a little bit at their own 44-yard line instead of in our territory, and then they hit a seam route.
I tell you, he's got a tremendous arm, he's as good as advertised. He's a special player.
I watched him in warm-ups, and it's he's good. And he's surrounded by a lot of good people.
Yes, he is. I mean, his receivers, I don't think they dropped one ball all night. I mean, they're like they had glue on there. Well, there's one drop.
There you go. They catch the ball.
Yeah, they do. You can't concentrate on one receiver either. They're all good.
Yeah, got good hands. Remind us of a couple of black and gold teams I've seen in the past.
Yep. I mean, a little out route to number 8.
Yeah, the ball gets there quick, folks. Mm-hmm. I mean, when you're down on the field and then nice cuts, they got a nice hole up middle. Their offensive line did a good job, and Creamer is able to. You give a running back or a receiver a ball one-on-one against one defender, and you expect the offense to win 90% of the time, and they do.
Yep.
All right, they're going to kick off to us again. Yeah, you watch that kid warm up in pregame, and it's impressive.
Mm-hmm. What's disappointing is they whipped us up front on both sides of the ball, which we thought we could play with them up front. We thought we could move the ball a little bit, but we just didn't get it done.
Balin rolls to the right-hand side, looking down deep, looking for his brother, and boy, what a catch by Brannon.
Brandon's going to be a good football player. He's still young. We're playing some 10th graders in some key positions. But I thought Brandon made a good catch there. Here goes Gavin on the good job on the pile read. And, we get about 4 yards.
It was a good read.
Yep.
Because Aliko took one right in the mouth.
Mm-hmm.
He pulled that ball out and got a nice read on it. We got him in a quarterback still. Fakes, looks downfield, and number 4 is right there.
There's number 4.
Yes.
Batting the ball down again. I tell you, he's a transfer. 14's a transfer. 28's a transfer. They got a lot of kids that came in to help that program, obviously.
Yes.
We throw a little screen here, and they close on it in a hurry. They're a good football team, and then we get a break. They call a personal foul.
A little chippiness after the game.
Yep.
Or after the play, rather.
Yep.
Balin's got it.
Yeah, we got to hit it right in the middle there, which is what we coached up all week.
They're going to call holding against us, which is going to back us up a little bit. We're back at their 41-yard line. Two receivers left. We freeze them at the line of scrimmage, get the right play. Aliko shifts to the left-hand side. JC with the snap. Design run, and here comes Balin. They're pretty strong. They fight through a couple blocks, Coach.
Yeah, they're really aggressive, and they've done a good job defensively to put their guys in space to make plays, throw a little screen, and they batting a bunch of balls down there. Yeah. They're very athletic, even on the edge.
And a little bobblehead action.
Oh, yeah.
After the plays.
A little offsides on them, I believe.
Yeah, they lined up offsides. Yeah. The DB on the other side came up, put his foot right on the 40-yard line, then leaned over.
Yep.
So he was in the neutral zone. We freeze him at the line of scrimmage again. Two receivers left, two right. We're on a drive here. We'd love to get this one finished off, Coach. Back, Balin takes his time looking over the middle. And
you know, we just got to catch the ball. You know, Balin struggles throwing the ball sometimes, but sometimes he's really good throwing the football. And, you know, the rule of thumb I had when I played receiver, if it hits me in the hands, we got to catch it.
There you go. I agree. Little pooch kick. We do this a couple times during the game, and this is probably the first time Balin's done this in his life.
Yep.
The next one is really good.
Yeah.
Yeah. He just got a little bit too much of the ball, but that's the least of our complaints. Little play action fake. They throw the ball downfield, and we had good coverage.
Good job by Rhett Abernathy. I tell you, Rhett's really, really played well for us with one hand. I'll be glad when he gets that cast off.
So will he be.
They throw the ball deep down. This is a great catch.
Yeah. He just goes up and gets it. We got double coverage. Got him behind and short.
We just got to make plays. When, you know, the ball's in the air. It's got to be ours, too.
Yes. Owen Williams comes from the right-hand side of the defense.
That's a good job by Malik.
Read the ball well.
Yep.
And this is what we thought going into the game, that Lawrence would try to force some situations and we could get some multiple turnovers. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, he played a pretty good game. Aliko going to the left-hand side. I think Aliko's going to struggle with a thigh bruise later in the game.
Yes, a little thigh contusion.
Nice medical term, Coach. Stepping up into the pocket. And that's Gavin Gray throwing a deep ball.
Yeah. He wasn't a very good read, but we're taking a chance there. And, you know, Gavin's just young.
Sophomore. Got bumped around in the pocket, and as he gets older and stronger, he'll take that hip check a little bit better. Holding against the jacket's going to back us up.
I think they declined
it.
They declined it.
They're going to take fourth down. Aaron Hayes in. And this is his only bad punt of the night.
Yep.
And then, you know, on top of the not going very far, it takes a Cartersville roll. Mm-hmm. One of those nights, Coach.
I think this is the second drive they've started on the 29-yard line, if I'm not mistaken.
I think you are correct, sir.
Good tackle by Rhett Abernathy. They had a couple of holding calls on that play, which they did. They tackled us.
Well, back here on the 30, yep. I mean, it was a takedown in a wrestling match. I got a kick out of the referee saying, Coach, which one of these you want to take? Duh.
Yeah.
I'm going to take the one further back. But they have to ask. All righty. Backs them up to our 41-yard line. Quarterback rolls to the right. And he throws one over the head. That's Malik Lawrence on the coverage out there. Quarterback rolls again to the right.
That's a good throw.
Yeah.
Good catch.
Yeah, and he catches number six. Seven's a hard runner to bring down. This kid throws the ball on the run as well as he does from the pocket.
Yes, he does. He's
very athletic.
He's got it all.
Yeah.
And he knows the offense, and the receivers know what to do. They run good routes. And They're very tough to deal with.
Yeah, if seven's not his favorite target, he's got three or four others to pick on. And they lined this young man up at wing back and then just slid him into the end zone, and he was wide open. We were playing a run, and I think some of the guys bit on a run fake. Yep. Now, that's why the kicker came up limping a little bit after that, and I wondered why.
Tyler's given tremendous effort on that extra point.
Yes, the whole night.
Tyler Putnam is as good as a kid there is. He works extremely hard, and we didn't work much on the kickoff return team because the kid kicks it in the end zone average, and then they brought in another kick, and we're able to get decent yardage, 25-yard line.
So here we go. We don't handle the snap real well. Unfortunately, we got it covered up pretty quick because number four was on us fast. Yeah, that kid plays good defense, number four.
Yeah, he's a good player.
Yeah.
I got good players all over the field. There's not a bad player out there.
Oh, no.
We got a little tunnel screen here and good yardage.
Brandon showed good patience, following his block and picking the right area to go into. Good gain to 26. We'll take that on every down. Then a nice pass here, a nice little hitch.
Yep, a little curl route for a first down. Maybe our first down of the night, if I'm not mistaken.
It was. First and 10 Jackets, three receivers right. Olico to the right of shotgun Balin. And they get to the ball quick, Coach.
Yes, they do. Downhill linebackers that are very aggressive, and they do a good job coaching them up. They're a good football team.
Yes.
Across the board.
And once again, we got to catch the ball.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was watching you before the game ever started. You knew quite a few of the guys on their staff.
Yeah, I do. I coached a good bit of those guys over there.
Yes. Line up to punt again, and Aaron will get off a better punt. Good snap from Jacob Callahan. Good extension, good follow through. Seven's got it, and he goes to the outside, and he's going to get a good return here, Coach. Had a little bit of a wall set up, and he's slippery.
Yeah, they do a good job with that, too. You know, he's a good return guy, but I thought we got to get down the field a little bit faster and get on him. Good job by James Prater.
Yeah, he just met the guy in a hole and hung on and brought him down. They've got the ball at our 34-yard line. Yeah, this is just a quick little bubble screen on after the play fake. And
yeah, there's a story behind number 84. You know, he's a starter last year in the secondary and at wide out, and this is his first game back because he just became eligible on last Friday.
Really?
I could go on and on about that, but I'm going to
let it go.
Yep, let it go.
Nice read by the quarterback. Shoestring tackle. We get him down at the 2-yard line. Let's make him run another play, Coach. Make him earn it. They line up in their heavy shotgun running formation. And quarter, this is the play where neither one of the side judges ever signaled a touchdown.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I'm looking. I said on the radio, it's a touchdown. He's in the end zone. And finally, the referee that spots the ball brought it back out to the 3, and they kicked the extra point, and they've got another one on the board. 4:22 left in the first half. Yeah, Todd and I were talking about it. I said, well, they put the ball down to 3 to kick an extra point. It's obviously a touchdown. And they got the regular kicker, Cruz, back in there, and he nails one long into the end zone. And this one, he actually put some direction onto it.
Yeah, he's a special kicker.
Yeah, we know that feeling.
Are we starting on the 20 again?
Yes, we are, sir.
We got a really good play
here.
Good run by Lico. Get a first down, 10-yard gain.
10-yard gain. First and 10 for the Jackets.
Well, they said it was second and 1. I said, guys, the ball's on the line. It's a first down.
I was saying the same thing on the radio. I had your back, Coach. They gave us first down. Well, they didn't give it to us. We earned it. Javard Williams in motion. Handed off to Olico. Little stutter step. Hits across 30. Yep. Gets up to 33. That's a good 3-yard gain. Robbie's Raiders giving us some running room. Motion. And I got a kick out of the college game the night before. They called that a jet sweep, and I assume it's the same in college, but that's actually a forward pass.
Yes, it is.
It's a jet sweep when you hand it off, I guess. Ooh, I thought that was interference.
Yeah, I did too. I really thought he had him all over his back, and that would have been a big first down for us.
Forced us to punt. Yeah, I was kidding on the radio. He had his dance card out. He had his arm wrapped around our receiver's waist.
Good job by Canyon Turner getting down the field, making the tackle.
Good job by Canyon Turner.
Canyon's gotten better.
Yeah,
he is. He's getting better.
Throw it out here to number 7. And
good play by Bryson Davis.
Yeah, it's nice to have Bryson Davis back, isn't it?
But that play was actually made by Red Abernathy because he
blew it up.
Blew it up, yep.
Yeah, we said the same thing on the radio. You got to take out that blocker.
Finally got some pressure on Lawrence.
Coach, he is human. We put pressure on him. He didn't throw the ball that well. Nice coverage downfield.
Yep, they caught a late hit on us here, which I didn't think it was a late hit. And even after watching the film last night, I didn't think it was.
I agreed with you. Personal foul, roughing the passer.
But fortunately, they caught a penalty on them, too, so they offset.
Offset, exactly. Three receivers up top. They're going to throw the ball again, folks. Quarterback takes his time, got good coverage, and this is a nice play.
Good job by Ryan Randall there.
On a big kid.
Yep.
And we had good downfield coverage. They were looking deep, had to go to the dump-off guy, and Ryan was right there to tackle him. Third and long. Lawrence steps up into the pocket and then scrambles. There's good coverage sack. And Bailey Lester on the play.
Good job by Bailey.
They called intentional grounding. It's lost the down. It's going to bring up fourth down.
We forced them to punt the football, which is this their first punt?
Yes, it is.
And the punter is really good, too. He's the kicker. He punted for them last year. No. He came in and substituted last year in the state championship game and did it. Their punter got hurt early in the state championship game, and this kid came in and punted and did well for him.
We sent 10 guys on the line of scrimmage, and Ryan Randall works his rear end off to get a good 6-7 yards back. I mean, he was one on none. That was a good job. Balin rolls to the right-hand side, gets near the line of scrimmage, and throws it away because there wasn't anybody up open down there.
Yeah, Balin's just got to run the football in that case. I mean, he's runs same thing. We got a penalty, I believe.
Yes. Illegal procedure against the Jackets. Yeah, I was hoping he maybe tucked that ball and took off.
Mm-hmm.
Play, fake the pass to the right, and then the turf monsters reached up and grabbed his tootsies. And that's going to do the first half.
Yeah, it's not, you know, not what we wanted, obviously. So I'm thinking a lot as we're going to the locker room. So
was
what
I
I'm
going
to do, what we're going to do. And we had a come-to-Jesus meeting at halftime, and I thought we played better the second half early.
Yes. You
know, especially defensively, we had some fire in our gut a little bit. And then offensively, we still couldn't move the ball. But I was really pleased the way the kids came out in the second half.
Todd and I talked about that at halftime, and I said, you know, what do you think coach is going to say? And, you know, you're walking across the field, and I'm thinking with you, and I'm thinking, yeah, it's you. Where do you go? You know, you can go to one end of the scale or the other end of the scale, and it's interesting. I thought whatever you said at halftime and however you said it, you coached them up, and I thought we had a lot more, as you said, fire in the belly to start the second half, and that was good to see.
Yeah, that's the most disappointing thing is we came out flat, and there's no reason to come out flat because we had nothing to lose. They're a better football team than we were, and we just didn't come out and play for some reason. And, you know, I challenged them at halftime to at least come out. You know, we weren't going to beat them, just at least come out and show some heart and some character and play hard.
Yeah, pride.
Yep.
Yeah, there you go. Folks, just sit back in that Barca Lounger, grab you a Daddy-O's donut and your favorite drink, and you're going to watch the best doggone band in the land. The Pride of Georgia's Northland, led by band director Larry Brown, assisted by Sarah Knapp, and led on the field by drum major Sarah Green. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show.
We are dedicating our halftime shows to Mr. Michael Clark, longtime band director and friend, his wife Charlie, and the entire Clark family. The band will be performing All My Life, Play That Funky Music. Our drum break, Those Are Us, I Saw Her Standing There, and House of the Rising Sun, featuring Patrick Super's trumpet solo. The band is under the field command of drum major Sarah Green. Percussion instructor is Robert Melville. Bar instructor is Betsy Childers. Major head coach Tracy Faraba. Assistant coach Madison Baker. Our superintendent is Mr. Shel Taylor. Our principal is Mr. Peter Coon. Band directors are Larry Brown and Sarah Nash. Thank you. As the Jackets exit the field, we would like to say a special thank you to Mr. Michael McIntyre and his tire store, and Stephen Cosby and family for helping us with our trailer tires last week. Thank you very much. Also, we want to wish a special happy birthday.
Welcome back to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. And like we talked earlier, going into halftime, we come out of halftime and we're going to kick off. We won the coin toss. We took the ball at the beginning of the game. And I thought the guys, I saw a little more hop in the step at the beginning of the third quarter.
Yeah, I thought we played, you know, especially the first 6 or 7 minutes.
Yes.
And then we might have had a turnover or two. And then, but I really thought we came out and played a little better. Good job by Juan kicking the end zone.
Second touchback of the season.
Yep. So we play, you know, we got a little more fire in our belly right here on this series here in the next series, I think.
Yes.
Pressure by James and.
And the quarterback scrambles and picks up 6 yards. It'll be second and four as he repositions his offensive set. Fakes to the running back, and then he hits that kid, and that's why he wanted him over on that side. It's, just,
yep.
It's almost like a tight end look-in pass from the wing position.
Yep.
Ooh, he almost lost the ball.
Yep, that was a good hit by Bailey Lester.
Yeah.
And they had a flag, but, you know, they got the best of both worlds with number 28. He can play tight end. He can play slot. He can play wide out. So they don't have to change personnel when they get their two-back set in.
Exactly.
Now we got pressure by Balin and the whole defense there, much better.
Balin gets the sack, and Coach, he's human. We make him move, and he's not near as good.
Mm-hmm. I think I was really proud of Balin last night. I thought he led the football team a lot better than he has. I was really pleased with his attitude last night.
I saw him before the game during warm-ups, and I thought he was really ready to play.
Yep.
And then they shank a punt.
We force them to punt the football, mm-hmm. and, you know, we come out and we play great defense and we got great field position and, you know, Lico's out with a bruised
Zach
thigh.
Fuller running.
And that was a read by Balin there. Didn't really see the read. It could have gone either way.
Exactly. Pick up a yard. Low snap. Balin gets on it. Then
That's a good job by Balin getting rid of the ball. We just got to do things perfect. You know, we're not good enough to overcome. You know, we're 3rd and 10 here, and we're not a good 3rd and 10 team right now.
Not many teams are, but we need some help there. And then we overthrow Zach Fuller, who's running a little down and out of the backfield. We do a little pooch, and this is so close, Coach. I mean, we're hustling downfield. Save the ball. Unfortunately, when we threw the ball back onto the field to play, Malik was standing in the end zone.
The ball really took a bad bounce on us. It got on the ground in a hurry and kept going.
Oh, and it rolled away from the strip. But we ran it down.
Yep. Good job by Brandon Spector. And I think Brandon is going to really be a good player, and he's having to play a lot as a 10th grader. But
That's okay.
Yep. He's going to be fine.
Yeah, that's fine. There'll be a play later on in the game where he takes a little bit of a banging, and it was really nice to see the first guy to him was his older brother.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was nice. All right, backs them up, personal foul against them. They're back. We got them back inside the 10. Quarterback fumbles the ball. Now he scrambles to the right-hand side, looking for somebody downfield. And, of course, he's going to find one of those glue-fingered receivers.
They do a good job with the scramble drill. When he scrambles, the receivers do a good job of getting open.
And they come back to him. Play fake. Quarterback goes to the outside. We've got to keep that outside contained, don't we?
Yep. I mean, we got it played. We got a good call there. And James has just got to stay on his feet. Run through him.
Force him to punt.
Again, this is the second time our defense has forced him to punt. Good job by Tyler putting pressure on the punter.
Yeah.
Good job by Ryan fielding it. So we got decent field position again. We're on the minus 45-yard line.
He tried to outrun five of them.
Mm-hmm.
Put his shoulder down there and got us some positive yards and get it out here to Bryson Davis.
Throw a screen out here for 0 or 1.
We gave you 1.
We got numbers out here, what we want, and they're more physical than us right now. And You know, number one's been playing for a long time. He's a very, I think he's been recruited as a corner, to be honest with you.
Really?
Yep. And then we're just shooting ourselves in the foot. You know, it's not what we want to do, and, you know, we just got to get better.
We throw a deep ball and just not right on target there. So we're going to go back. It creates fourth down. Aaron's going to do the punting again. Puts his foot in the ball, and he gets off a good punt here, Coach. Nice hang time. Oh, look at that by Javard Williams.
Good
nice
job.
Coverage.
Yeah, good job by Javard. You know, Javard's got to get better. You know, he's just a junior as well.
Nice move at the line of scrimmage, back to the left-hand side, and then he's down the field quickly.
That kid's a good player. He sees the hole well.
Yes, he does.
Throw a little pop pass again and to 28. And
Turf Monster's got him.
Yep.
But not before he gets the first down. We'll use a little bit of help here. We'll take it. Just missed the seam route. We had two guys on it, and I was hoping we were going to pick that off.
That was a good throw. Just dropped the ball, but we've got to break on the ball a little bit. Throw a screen right here, and we come back, and, you know, we're playing hard, and, you know, we're physical, and they're physical. And
well, we stood the blocker up. Mm-hmm. Actually pushed the blocker back into the receiver. That slowed things down. I got a new running back in there. Number 22, quarterback drops back and through the hands, and I was hoping a tip stay in the air. Balin was ready to pick that off. Two receivers left, two right. We're coming with a blitz. Here comes Balin, and they're going to blow it dead because it's illegal procedure.
Again, I thought they could have called more penalties, illegal procedure. I thought the wideouts were jumpy all night.
Constantly. Got some pressure on the quarterback. He scrambles, rolls to the left-hand side. Looking downfield, and he's going to find a guy at the side. Ooh, a slobber knocker by Rhett.
Good hit by Rhett. I mean, we got pressure on the quarterback, and we trip over each other. I mean, we got kids unblocked, and we can't stay on our feet. We put more pressure on them. They got a good call here to the screen, to number 84.
Tunnel screen.
It's been eligible for 5 days.
Yeah.
When I say eligible, he hadn't been practicing. He can't practice when he's ineligible.
Right. Well, the rich get richer.
Yep, that's right.
There you go. Nice pressure again.
Yeah, we're doing a good job putting pressure on the kicker. We just got to do a better job of stopping them and forcing them to field goals.
4.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Kick it down to the two or three. Brandon drops it, picks it back up, comes hard to left-hand side. And then coming from the left, he takes a hard hit, ball pops loose, and they recover it on the 15.
Yep, and it just continues to go downhill.
Yes, it does. Yes. When it rains, it pours, Coach. Ask South Georgia. This is a nice play.
Yep. That is very, very difficult to defend.
That's
right.
It's
his own read, and you know, if it's a pull, you know, he's got the outlet to the screen. It's just very difficult to defend. And
he could have run the ball if he wanted.
And you got, when you got a quarterback like that can do it, he's it makes it very difficult.
They get a touchdown off the turnover. Yeah, Todd and I both remarked that that's a nice play. That puts a lot of pressure
on
the
defense. Yes, it does.
So they kick the extra point, and they're going to kick off to us again.
You just can't turn the ball over and inside your 15-yard line, it's very difficult to deal with.
Yeah, their starting field position for the evening was very, very good.
I guess it was on the plus side, wasn't it?
Yes, it was on the plus side. Down to the 3-yard line, return the ball up the middle. Ryan Randall coming up, and he gets it across the 20. We're going to have it first and 10 at our 23-yard line. Got Gavin Gray at quarterback, and we're starting to substitute now, aren't we, Coach?
Yep. We've got some we've still got our starting offensive line in there, but we brought Gavin in and
give him some experience.
Yep. And then 84 just sits on it.
Yeah, he sat on that route
yep.
real well.
And he's really he's a veteran because he's been a two-year starter before this year.
Took care of some off-the-field issues, and now he's back playing. All righty, they kicked the extra point, and they got a new extra point guy in there. Once again, putting pressure on it. And I'll tell you what, Tyler Putnam busting his hump from the outside, isn't he?
Oh, yeah.
3 minutes left in the third quarter. Like we said, they have a new kickoff man.
At this point, this game couldn't get over fast enough.
Right. Exactly. They're going to kick this one out of bounds. We're going to take over at the 35-yard line. It'll be first and 10. So we got Balin back at quarterback. And we give it to Jakeenan Dixon. He bangs up in there, gets back to the line of scrimmage. So now we've got Zach Fuller. Fuller back at running back. Balin gives it to him.
It's a good run by Zach.
Good hard run.
Good read. He's reading offensive line. And
he has good vision, coach.
Yeah, he does. He's a hard-nosed kid.
Quick feet.
Yep.
Might not be the fastest guy in the world.
No, but he's...
Line up and play every down for you.
He plays fast.
Yes, he does. Down and out here on the left-hand side, and we go up for it, and pretty good defense. Pass is just a little bit high, trying to find Porter Law on that route. We're going to let Aaron Hayes punt it one more time. Puts his right foot to the ball. Low line drive kick. And they field it at their 26-yard line. That was actually his longest punt of the night, 39-yarder. Hmm. They've got some subs in, low snap, quarterback spins. This is their freshman quarterback.
Yep, this is the next one in line. He's a good player, too.
Flip the field, fourth quarter. And as you wished for earlier, this quarter's going to play pretty quick.
Yep.
They send two receivers to the right, wing to the right, give to the running back.
We got some subs in there who are backups. You got Colin Baggett, Davis Allen, linebacker, and Zach Fuller. You got Beck Fletcher at nose.
Little swing pass out to the right-hand side, and they get downfield and is able to pick up a first down. Yeah, Colin Baggett.
He's just a sophomore. We think he's got a chance to be really good.
Yeah, we call his name a lot.
Yep, good job by Zach Fuller.
Yeah, there's Zach playing at 100 miles an hour. Mm-hmm. Good job. Colin Baggett in there helped Beck Fletcher also.
Jacob Callahan in there at Stinger. Porter Law at Rover.
Yep. Quarterback rolls to the right-hand side.
Ooh, that's a good play by Jacob.
Yeah, nice solid hit by Jacob.
I thought that was a chop block on Zach Fuller there. They didn't call it. They got pressure here and throw a screen.
Zeke Nance reacting back to it, saw the screen, came back, helped out on the tackle with Davis Allen.
Oh, Davis.
Mm-hmm.
Got three sophomore linebackers in there, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Good job by Zach.
Look at him coming in hard, fast. Nice read, Zach. You're going to.
So they turn the ball over to us and.
On downs. Nice stop. Nice little read there. Pulled the ball out of Porter Law's belly, and Gavin met some resistance at the line of scrimmage. Loss of one, second and 11. Nice pass, nice
good,
catch.
Good throw, good catch. Everybody Jabbard, good throw by Gavin.
Going to bring up third down at the 45-yard line. Ooh, big pressure. And he tried to find Tyler Putnam because, boy, Gavin was under a lot of pressure.
Yeah, it was a tunnel screen. We were trying to get off there. So it's fourth down. I think it's fourth down.
You're right, it is, from the 45. Tipped at the line of scrimmage, and we were trying to set up where.
Another screen.
Yeah. So they take over on downs. They've got motion from left to right. There's your jet sweep running to the right-hand side. Good hustle by Zach Fuller. Came from the opposite side of the field, coach.
He's got an unbelievable motor.
Yeah, folks, at practice, his motor runs, he plays hard, and he talks a lot.
Yep.
I mean, he's a good leader.
Yep, he is.
And the running back went down. The officials were slow to spot this, and fortunately, everybody kind of slowed down once. Mm-hmm. I mean, we on defense realized his knee was down too. I think the officials were getting tired. Hand off to the running back, little jet sweep to the left-hand side. This 88, the wing, is a sophomore.
He's another move in.
So they got a big guy to replace 28.
Yep, they do.
I don't think he's as athletic.
No.
All righty, they got a wing to the right. Give it to number 22. He's slowing down a little bit. He breaks the seam. He's down the field. Gets inside the 10-yard line. And then Cartersville is going to pretty much let the clock run out here.
Yep.
And they did. So we got 2 weeks to work on some things and get a whole lot better. Region plays coming up. We're going to have homecoming in Kahala Creek in 2 weeks. So health-wise, how did we come out of the game?
Well, you know, we're beat up. You know, Red Abernathy's beat up. Yes. Ryan Randall's beat up. Alico's beat up. But, you know, that's the least of our worries right now. We've got some other things we got to iron out as a coaching staff. And, you know, I told the kids, you know, it's important to see where we go from here. You know, we can tuck our tail and be done with this thing, or we can show a little character and pride and come back Tuesday ready to go to work.
Exactly. We're going to take a time out, and we're going to come back and talk about the pipeline. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Welcome back to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. And, Coach, we started playing some middle school ball, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, middle school had their first game Thursday. They beat South Central 28-0, which was a good start for our middle school. And then our JV is actually starting this week, which is, you know, I know they're tired of practicing and not playing. We open up with Ringgold at home Thursday at 5:30, so we're excited about that.
Thursday at 5:30, so come on out and support the pipeline. I know the pipeline is going to keep being full. And, hey, folks, don't lose faith. This team's going to get better. The coaching staff's going to work hard. The boys are going to work hard. There's a lot of character on this team, and things are going to improve. And I can't wait to get back out on the field in 2 weeks and take on Kahala Creek at homecoming and start the region off 1-0. Let's start a new win streak.
Yeah, we're going to get better. It's going to take some time. And, you know, we had a huge, huge setback this Friday. But, you know, the bottom line is we played a really good football team and we didn't play very well. And when that happens, you know, the score's going to get lopsided. So my hat's off to Cartersville. But, you know, I think our kids – after our talk last night, you know, after the game, I think our kids will be ready to go. You know, we're going to give them Labor Day off since we're off next week, and we'll come back to work on Tuesday.
And back to work you will go.
Yep.
There you go. I'd like to thank Coach Bill Long's video broadcasting class. The producers for today's show were Manuel Fitz and Phoebe Jude, and the directors were Eduardo Fajardo and Caitlin Green. Folks, you can watch the Boys of Fall anytime you want by going to CalhounTDClub.com. That's CalhounTDClub.com. Coach, I'm ready to get back on the field. I'm ready to get this ball rolling again, so we'll get back at it in 2 weeks and take on Kahala Creek and show the Colts what Calhoun football's like.
Yep. Thanks, Dave.
You've been watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show.